council, let's call this meeting in order. Rise for the Pledge of Allegiance, please. Pledge allegiance.
To the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I can remind everybody to please silence their phones, including me, especially me. First order, has everybody had an opportunity to review and approve the regular session minutes from November 4th, as well as our special joint session with the commissioners on the 17th?
Yes.
Are there any questions? Motion to accept them?
As noted.
Second?
Second.
We have a motion and a second to approve the minutes from our November 4th regular session and our November 17th meeting. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. Anybody have any mail?
Nope.
Okay. We'll move on to our county attorney. Are you going to address the ordinances or?
Yes, I am.
Because I'll probably cut you off on the knees on that one real quick just to speed it up.
Okay.
We're probably just going to have a special session to review them because we just literally received them 5-10 minutes ago. And we haven't had an opportunity to review them to make sure that they're correct. And I just say it'd be prudent that we, as a council, be able to go through them, not here necessarily.
Okay, well, I was going to say.
Maybe that'd be our recommendation.
I was going to recommend that we get the okay from the State Board of Accounts that what is proposed as far as the funding of these.
And that would allow us time to do that.
Because it's a little bit unique what they're, what the proposal is asking.
Yeah, so I think it would be, make good sense to do that, to delay it and schedule a meeting for 2 weeks out so we can get the proper notification and do our due diligence and the researching of the proposed ordinances and make sure that the State Board of Accounts is okay with what we're proposing.
Well, you don't want to discuss them at all?
We can discuss them, but like I say, I think all of it's up to the council. It's not my sole decision.
Well, I think because you guys haven't had time to review it and they haven't addressed these at a special session or another session. The effective date is January 1, but once these longevity, I mean, it's already in place, but for 2016.
Correct. But we want to, yeah, like I say, get that done this year, dot our I's and cross our T's and make sure that that's done properly. So, I guess that leaves the 15th. 'Would that be okay with the council to meet again on the Wednesday? And the other part, the reason to do this too, is I don't want Gertrude getting off the hook thinking she can only meet with the council once this month. So we want to make her suffering last.
That's a good idea.
And it's joint, the Democrat and Republican both agreeing.
I think the 15th would be just fine for me. 6 o'clock?
Yeah.
On me.
Okay. So you want to make a motion to that, or?
Can we make it rush?
No, please, because I'll have to do advertisements. So.
Could somebody make a motion to that effect?
Yeah, I'll move we schedule a special session for Tuesday, December the 15th at 6 p.m. for consideration of these three proposed ordinances that we've just been presented.
Okay. Second?
Second.
Shirley. Okay, thank you, Council, for your flexibility in that. We have a motion on the floor to hold a special meeting to review the three ordinances that have been proposed to us tonight and to check with the State Board of Accounts to make sure that we are doing everything correctly. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. Ayes have it, motion carries. See, Chris, I've watched Perry Mason a time or two.
Yeah.
Thanks. I just think if we haven't had a chance to review, we're asking them to approve something that they haven't had a chance to.
I was going to recommend that anyway.
Sure you were.
If I'm not here. Well, besides that, I don't have anything else to bring before the council, unless you guys have a specific question or concern.
Thank you for putting these together. Appreciate it. I know we have nothing from the committee as far as finance or the financial side. Budget?
No, we've got nothing to report.
Shirley, probably you haven't worked on anything either?
No, and the ordinances really need to be incorporated with what we've done, you know, included with the secondary information we're gathering for each of the employees.
So you've got your work cut out for you the next couple of weeks. Christmas shopping and this.
Yes.
Ms. Wise, and I will let the full council know, at this special meeting, council will also be voting on the salary ordinances for 2016 that have the classifications as the council requested during the budget hearings.
Okay. Moving on to commissioner's representative, I don't think we have one here. But in the meeting this morning with the commissioners, they talked about a joint meeting with us and our first meeting in January, which is the 5th. If we could meet with them at 5 p.m., so move our time up an hour early, so that we can get our appointments in place, get that done right away. We have to talk, and there's going to be a public hearing on, is it WTH?
Yes.
With the ADA? Is it GIS or ADA?
WTH is the public hearing to allow the county to sell the mapping details for third parties.
So we have to meet with them because it obviously concerns our side as well as the commissioners. So so just make a note that we'll be meeting at 5 p.m. with the commissioners on the 5th of January. Which should mean we go home an hour earlier. Should. Okay. I think that was all from the commissioners. Am I missing anything, am I? Concerning the council?
I think you covered the highlights.
Okay.
I think they said that they're going to be coming to ask for appropriations for fees. Legal fees.
Oh, that night?
Just at the beginning of the year, just to clarify.
And this is something I think the council understood was for the $8,000 for the Area Plan Commission attorney. That's going to be moved to 2016 for an additional.
That was part of it. They got just the cost of doing business with legal fees and some of the stuff that's transpired over the past year. They've been hit heavy with attorney fees from various things that are going on that we have to do. And brought up in the commissioner's meeting, if there's any way we can address some of these attorneys to get those to us sooner than the end of the year, because of course we're hurting at the end of the year with, and we don't have a lot of extra money if ever, and they were going to try to work on that. So I think it was part of it too, was that was included in that, hitting us up for additional fees, just so you're aware of that.
In that special meeting, I asked the commissioner to get the breakdown of that invoice. Never have seen.
Okay, I'll follow up with President Jackson and make sure that we get that, because you are correct.
Okay, thank you.
Dan Parker, would you like to have your 5 minutes of fame?
Sure. Short report. Good evening to each of you. We continue to work on the formation of the Regional Planning Commission with, as you'll recall, five counties, Fayette, Randolph, Rush, Union, and Wayne. There's a meeting this Thursday evening in Richmond that I'll attend on the steering committee for the SET or SET or Stronger Economies Together, which, as you'll recall, is part of the information gathering to lead us to the comprehensive economic development strategy that will be used for that regional planning commission. regarding the ACT work-ready communities. We are at 91% of the goals that we need to have Fayette County as a certified work-ready community. We are 38 transitioning individuals. That's all we need to complete all of our goals, which we will most likely complete during 2016. They give us 2 years to complete that, and we will easily do that within a 1 year time frame. I continue to work on 8 to 10 ongoing projects, of which I cannot give you specific details to here in public, but I certainly can to each of you individually later. Beyond that, it is a short report. I want to thank each of you for your support for economic development and your, not just your verbal support, but also your financial support. It means a lot. It's an important initiative for our county to move forward. And I appreciate it, and our board appreciates it. Do you have any questions for me? I appreciate that. So with that, I'll get off the podium here. But before I go, I'd like to wish each of you a Merry Christmas and a very happy and prosperous New Year.
Thank you. Right. Same to you. We have no old business that I'm aware of. And there is no new business other than the additionals. Okay, we have an additional appropriation for Board of Zoning and Appeals for the amount of $400. Everybody has a copy of this, correct?
Correct.
Okay. It's for the initial, it states the initial budget was insufficient to pay the five BZA members $30 a month for 2015 due to special meetings, which canceled out the usual savings due to not all members attending all meetings and not all meetings being held. High attendance for scheduled meetings and extra meetings due to whitewater wind shot the underfunded line item. And we talked about this in our budget last year when we were preparing it, that we knew that the meetings weren't all being held, but then we didn't foresee the amount of meetings that were going to be held for due to the wind energy, so I guess I'm not surprised.
Yeah, Bill called me about this morning, and he asked if he had to be here for this, and I said, well, yeah, we prefer you to be, but, you know, he had the same with his dad. He had to take care of his dad, so that's basically what, like I said, it was just for the additional meetings. So.
Mark, do you know how many members?
BZA?
Yeah, how many members we owe for how many meetings?
No, I don't know how. I have to go back and look, see how many meetings were canceled. There's five members on it. And I don't know how, I can't remember how many special meetings there were. They have more meetings than what the ACC does, so I don't know exactly how many were not. I know we had several months this last year we did not have meetings because there was no business. But I don't know about the BCA.
Reason I ask.
I don't, the one thing I didn't ask Bill, I don't know if there's any money left in the APC budget that maybe they could transfer. I didn't ask that. I didn't think about that.
There is none. If I could just inform council, correct. We had discussions already with Mr. McDaniel with the auditor's office, try to see where we could possibly transfer between the BZA and the APC funds and appropriations, and there just is none, because it's not just the members, but the attorney fee that is has come up now quite a bit higher than what was appropriated. So that option has been looked at, and there is nothing to go with.
Okay.
I will inform council that as far as the county general surplus out of which this additional is being requested, we do have enough to cover this if council decides to go that direction.
What is our balance, do you know?
It was at $3,400, last I checked.
What's council's pleasure in this?
Gertrude, you indicated there is, there are funds to...
Correct. I sent out an email just before the middle of November for the deadline for additionals to do the advertising to all of our county department heads to let them know that we only have about $3,400 left in our county general surplus, and that only those items that have priority would be considered for the additionals, since December 1st was our, technically our last meeting. So we do have enough in the funds, Ms. Wise, to cover this $400 with a little bit left over.
I move that we approve the $400 requested to pay the 5 BZA members.
We have a motion on the floor to approve the additional request for $400 to pay the 5 BZA members. Is there a second?
I'll second it.
We have a second. Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
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 Opposed, nay?
Nay.
One nay. Advise that. Motion carries. Next up, transfers. And we got two for the commissioners. There's a view for you, isn't it? One of the commissioners' budget.
It is. I'll speak on this since we do not have a commissioner's representative here today. We had an enormous amount of legal ads in this year that we had to post as required by the different state agencies for anything for new ordinances that had fees attached to just the general tax rates and so on. And because bids, for example, and that line item was exhausted and needs to have some additional monies transferred to that, and so that's where the commissioners have presented this for approval of the transfer.
I move that we approve the transfer of $1,227 from the unemployment fund to the legal notice.
What did we just do? That is passed on mine.
I'll second your motion, Shirley.
Okay, we have a motion on the floor to approve it. I'm sorry. Shirley, did you say to approve it?
Shirley made the motion and I second.
Thank you. Motion to approve the transfer request, the auditor's office. All those in favor say aye.
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 Opposed, nay. Ayes have it. Motion carries. So what did I ask?
This is the BZA additional. I should have gone with the resolution.
Oh, okay. That's why I'm distracted.
And then okay. This is the one that you just signed to take that back as well.
Okay. Can you sign this one?
Yes.
Mark's rules here are still in the process now. Okay, IT department, transfer request. How you doing, Michael?
Pretty good. The request is just to transfer money from the probation department for the fund that they had set up for the part-time IT for their dedicated time to my line item for the part-time IT person. That money ran out in just around the beginning of October because I was not aware that the other departments had not, that money had been transferred as something set up that Ben had done. So he's been out of work while we got the contract straightened out between those three departments and the county IT side of things so that we can get this straightened out. But I can bring him back to work if you transfer the money from the probation IT funds that they had set aside into my line item.
Okay, which is what we all agreed upon
yeah.
previously.
Yeah.
Michael, you got the contracts now with all three of those departments?
Yeah, they're basically going to go from December to December, so.
If I could just do a follow-up to what Mr. King said on this, the $3,065.92, that is the probation's department agreement for the remainder of 2015. The money has already been taken out of the probation fund and transferred to County General to the unappropriated account, and that's where that's currently sitting. So probation has already given their part for this year, and we're just waiting now for council approval to take that out to put it into the IT part-time line item.
Okay. Somebody like to make a motion on that?
The probation has already paid us that, right?
Correct. Okay. And my office has already sent a written a check from the probation line item to the treasurer for the County General.
Okay.
I'll move to approve the transfer request for the IT department in the amount of $3,065.92.
I second the motion.
We have a motion and a second to
roll
approve.
Roll call, vote.
What?
I'm going to roll call, vote.
Okay. We have a motion to approve the $3,065.92 transfer request. We seconded. We'll do a roll call vote. Are there any more questions? Okay, we'll do a roll call vote.
Okay, roll call vote, starting with Councilman Jim Wolf.
No.
Councilwoman Wise.
Yes.
Councilman Seidel.
No.
Councilman Flum.
No.
Councilman Nobby.
No.
Councilman Strong.
Yes.
Councilman, well, let's first, we have a tie here at a, actually, no, we currently have a vote, 4 no's, 2 yeses.
Oh, I still get the vote.
And Councilman Wentz.
Yes.
3-4 and 4 against.
Motion failed. Let's check this approved.
Well, I'm going to have to check with the State Board of Accounts. I don't know if that can be done since this contract has been sent.
I thought that. There was a contract where the county agreed to pay half of the part-time salary, and we had to get, which was approved by the commissioners in 2014, to get their money from their respective agencies, they had to present a more definite contract, which was approved specifically for this position. I mean, the money.
I guess I don't understand why the no vote, when we talked about it in budget here and we knew about it for 2 years. This is the agreement was agreed to last year. It's been agreed to this year. The money's taken off from probation. They've already put it aside. It's there. It's not coming out of County General. It's coming out of the probation department. It's coming out of the other departments. And so I don't understand.
I didn't know the probation that money had to go for part-time help.
Yeah,
I thought it came into that line item just as for a full-time employee. I didn't know it was part-time too.
The only way probation could get that money was to present like
a part-timer,
a claim for a supplemental IT services, because they can't bill their
their grant guidelines
for a full-time employee. They can't get funds for that, but they can for supplemental IT.
So you're telling me that those funds that we agreed to when we first started this with the IT guy, that the probation would pay part of it, community correction would pay part of it, was for a part-time person?
Yep. Yeah, supplemental IT service.
I never caught it that way, but.
So.
That not when we started this. That's not the way it was. We only had one person.
No, it was for a part-time person.
It's always been for a part-time person that was.
And that was, it was an agreement because the one person, there was not enough hours to go around, and probation and community corrections both needed additional IT services. They had new computers that needed to go into service and just not enough hours. That's the way we approved it initially.
Yeah, but all the new computers have been brought up online.
that was the idea of it, you know, bringing part-time in to help out.
But the agreement that they entered into was that they were going to get this part-time IT person for some, they were guaranteed to have the part-time, access to the part-time IT person for so many hours. And in exchange, they would give X amount of dollars. It didn't matter if there were new computers and they were set up or whatever. It was an agreement that we entered into with them.
Well, could we see the agreement then? I just don't remember it that way, but I guess.
The agreements were just passed in November by the commissioners. I do have those in my office. If council wants to wait, I can bring those in. But those agreements are signed by the three department heads and the county commissioners.
I think that they'd have to send the money back.
Do you remember that?
Allocated for supplemental IT services.
Right.
So basically what you're telling me then is that the probation has hired a part-time person.
The commissioners.
They're paying for it, so I guess they have hired.
Yes, they, no, that's not what happened. They, commissioners, the county, and the community corrections, probation, and 911 all had an agreement that they were going to pay this part-time person. And each of those departments agreed to pay half of the salary, and the county commissioners agreed to pay the other half, which they have.
There's an actual part-time line item for this part-time IT person out of the commissioner's appropriations that council, since I think 2014, has approved the last 2 years this part-time appropriation. It's not enough to cover the amount of work that this person does. And in addition to that, probation, community correction, and third department, 911, because they have grant monies that they can use towards funding this IT support, they said, we'll be more than glad to chip in. However, they have to do it by a claim or by a contract per their grant responsibilities. And so apparently this has been sitting out there for 2 years, but no contract has actually been written until this year. And council did have extensive discussions on this during your budget hearings with each of those department heads.
What I would recommend is, if we're going to vote on something, just like I recommend at the beginning of the meeting, that we set aside these ordinances because we have not had time to review them. For 2 years, we've known about these agreements. So I don't understand what the confusion is. The agreements have been there. We've known it's grant money. It's not our money. It's grant money that's set aside to help pay for the part-time IT person. So what we're accomplishing by voting no is nothing, except hurting these departments that are supposed to have access to them.
Mr. President, if anyone needs further clarification on this question, could we have Michael and Jenna from probation and the other two departments and the auditor provide that clarification on the 15th? And if the council wants to take a second look at the issue, they can do it then.
Michael, do you have any thoughts? Come up to the podium, please.
The part-time IT person was approved in May of 2014 to be paid half from the commissioners. The other half was split between the three departments, guaranteeing them 4 hours of dedicated IT time per week. This was supposed to be not only for computers, but also for training, help in learning things just that they've never used or they want to use the capabilities of the software that they have available. Currently, I mean, Ben was the same way, but currently I have 70 things on my to-do list. Some of them are small, some of them are fairly involved projects that involve a lot of research and a lot of time. I'm working 55 hours a week just trying to keep up. I mean, that's not counting research that I do at home. Friday last week, everybody else was off, I was at work. So that part-time person can take care of some of the little day-to-day questions that people have, allowing me to get other things done here and at the city. Rushville, which is not a comparable size, they have one guy for the county, one guy for the city. full-time both places. So we need person here. If we wait till the 15th, we got 2 weeks left till the end of the year. So there's real, at that point, there'd really be no point in transferring the money. You just might as well wait till bringing back January 1st when he's allotted as part of my line items for 2016.
Has this part-time person been working?
No. Yeah. Not since Kathy told me that the money wasn't there. So he's been off. So I'm getting further behind. And there are a lot of little day-to-day things that I had him doing that for specific departments, for circuit court for one, burning DVDs of the backups of various recordings that people need.
So you have not had a part-time person working for how long?
For 2 months.
For 2 months. So now we've had that part-time money, as everybody's telling me, for part-time help, but we have not been using it.
Money
was spent.
Money was spent.
Yeah. The money is spent?
By October, I had gone through, Kathy Heimlich came to me, because I thought the money had been transferred from those departments, but all I had was the commissioner's portion.
Okay.
Now, between when Skylar left in February, who was my other part-time person, to hiring Michael Wilhelm, I had 2 months. It was April when I hired Michael. So when he came in to October, that used up the rest of the commissioner's portion of the fund. So I have not had access to the other three departments' money. So that's why I've not had anybody for 2 months.
Tanner, could you come up?
Yeah. I don't know if it would help to clarify. To explain from the probation's point of view that we agree for the part-time person because we needed the extra IT help back in 2014. The issue became there needed to be, in order for probation to take that appropriate money and put it in the correct place for the part-time person, I have to have it as a professional contracted service because probation user fees cannot supplant a job that's already paid by the county. We can only pay for something that would supplement. So it goes above and beyond what the county employee would normally provide to anybody in the department, and it has to specifically go towards probation. The contract, I don't know what happened because 911 does it differently. Community Corrections doesn't. It's coming out of different funds, and each department has specific statutes that they have to follow for that. That's why the contract was created, so that I would have that on record to show that that was going specifically so many hours extra above and beyond what IT normally does for the county anyway. And I will say that it would be difficult for us to function with the amount of work that the probation department has to do. We're already under the number of probation officers we should have per caseload. So we do rely a lot on IT and getting things done more efficiently and keeping data and statistics. We rely a lot on the IT. Mike has done training for us in order to better use the Zimbra email account. I'm doing a probation procedures manual. He's helping me set that up so it's automatically linked. There's a lot of things that I don't know IT-wise. And to be more efficient, if we have part-time and they set it up, then I can move on to something else that are my responsibilities. So I don't know if that kind of helps.
What did we do before we had IT and part-time IT person?
We didn't do the amount of work that we're doing now. We've done a lot. We have acquired so many systems. We've got the Odyssey system now that we use. We're not having to pay PBS anymore to maintain the system. We were paying a monthly fee. We have a Sentry web-based program that does evidence-based drug testing that's truly random, that the probation officers are told these are the people that are going to test today. so it's not, it's more consistent because it's picked out by the system. We're going to acquire a system that is a call-in system for low-risk probationers starting in January, where again, that's a whole web-based system that keeps track of the low-risk people, so we can focus our time on medium and high-risk probationers, but they still have to check in every month, they have to update addresses, it helps keep track of them. So we have consistently added programs where we need an IT person to help keep that flowing and efficient. I know when we do start a new system, I have their IT call our IT because I don't understand the language and what's, I'm just not computer savvy that way. I know what I need to do. So that's what we're using it for. We're using it for many different things.
What have you been doing for the last 2 months?
How many people? I'd say, well, the county's got 195 employees, and at least half of those use a computer. Not county, however many at the city. Prior to hiring Ben Houston as full-time IT and then adding part-time last in 2014, basically what would have been done is they would call Ron Best or somebody else to contract the service, or they would muddle through. If it was a little problem, they would try to muddle through it. In the meantime, while they're muddling it through, they're not getting their own work done. So we've cut the employees in all the departments so close that they don't have time to muddle through. They need to be able to call somebody, get back to work as quick as possible. Some of those things I can send Mike to do, some of them I go to do. In the meantime, we're both working on all the other stuff that has to get done. I know we're not necessarily a 24/7 in the rest of the courthouse, but I'm also 24/7 with jail, with 911, community corrections, these departments that have to be supported full time. Well, if I have to work overnight for something, I've got to have somebody to cover the courthouse while I take a couple hours off at least. And that part-time person is there to allow me to be able to take a vacation day or, you know, sick day. I haven't had a sick day in 2 years. So those are things that the part-time person that we also need for them to be there to cover while I'm either at the city dealing with a city issue or just out sick.
How many hours a week do you guys work at the city?
It varies. I mean, some weeks I work there 20 hours, some weeks I work there 10, some weeks it's 30. It just depends on what's going on.
I think what we need to do is have IT for the county, and not being disrespectful, but the county takes care of their business, let the city do theirs.
If you and the city agree with that, I would.
Commissioners have talked about that last year, and
that would be completely up to the council and commissioners.
It would help them somewhat, but for right now, with all due respect to the council members that voted no, I mean, I respect your opinion and so forth, but we're hurting the county employees. We're not doing anything but hurting the county employees. That's all we're doing. That's all we've done.
I'm trying to figure out what we did for the last 2 months. I mean, why wasn't this money recognized 2 months ago? I mean, what have you been doing for the last 2 months?
The problem was that I could not transfer the money until I had a contract, so we put into place in each agency had to have a different contract because they have different requirements for their statute.
Yeah,
the contract is what held it up. The money was appropriated.
So you just have a contract just started with the commissioners?
Oh, it started in May of 14, but they needed something more definite to get the money from their department.
I mean, I had budgeted it and it had gotten appropriated. It's a matter of figuring out how that money was supposed to get from probation to the line item that it needed to pay the part-time IT person. And that didn't come to my attention. That's what created the whole, we've got to get the contract done. Yeah. So the different departments, and Mike met with the county attorney to create that contract.
And part of that time was a matter of finding out from the hierarchy of probation, who they answer to and who corrections answer to, find out what was required, and we would have brought it in the November meeting, but we just missed it by a couple of days, so it got put onto this meeting.
I mean, that's part of the problem is when we meet, when the commissioners meet, advertising requirements and so forth, so that it's not like normal business where we can get it taken care of in a matter of 4 days. the government, and we're slow. Sometimes not too sharp.
And wasn't this money appropriated for
the
this
been
use
appropriated.
By this body?
Yes, it,
they
it
have
was.
Money, so how can they
I
not,
don't.
I don't even know.
That's a great question. Like I said, I respect their each opinion, but I don't understand the logic sometimes. So, does anybody else want to continue discussing this? Do we want to talk about it at our next meeting on the 15th? Do those members that voted no want to see the contract?
Yes, I'd like to see the contract and then lay it to the 15th.
Well, then I would invite each of you to go to the auditor's office and get a copy of it.
Okay.
All right. And we'll address it on the 15th, but like Michael says, in the meantime, it still puts him 2 weeks further behind. Treasurer. Right here. What would the council like to do? The treasurer is not here. Unless Gertrude wanted to speak to this. Or?
I will be glad to. Now, I did not speak with Treasurer Hires on this, but her request is simply she had to increase some of her part-time hours for her part-time person with the settlement on tax collections that they're doing. I know they're still getting on-time mail, and she's asking for this $300. She doesn't think that she's going to need the entire amount. The money's already been appropriated. It is in her budget, but she just needs to take what's left over from her, I believe it's her travel and training money, to transfer over to her personnel. And anything that's not used would go back to county general fund when we roll over at the end of this year.
Council, what would you like to do?
I'll move to approve the transfer.
We have a motion to approve the transfer request for $300. Is there a second?
I'll second.
We have a second. Any further discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay.
Aye.
Ayes have it. Motion carries. Prosecutor. You know anything about that? Well, we have no representative here from the prosecutor's office. Did she know she needed to be here? Or she's requesting $50.
Well, yeah,
she's requesting $50 to be transferred.
Approve the request for $50.
And again, I want to reiterate that all these transfers, whether it was the treasurer or now for the prosecutor's office, this is money that they already have appropriated into their budget. It's not additional money or new monies coming out of the fund. It's already been appropriated. It's their money. They're simply needing to go through what the State Board of Account requires if the monies are moved from different classification lines. So it's $50 to help pay out the salary for her investigator in her office.
Council, what would you like to do?
I'll make a motion. Pass it.
I thought I already did.
Surely did.
I'll
surely say. Did. The motion and a second. Any further discussion?
May I ask you a second?
Councilman Wolf. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. Ayes have it. Motion carries. 144 is Circuit Court. How you doing, Judge?
I'm fine, you?
Good. Did you have a good Thanksgiving?
Yes, you.
Did. Thank you.
Good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
We've had a few, I guess, just a personnel change in the circuit court. My longtime legal assistant, Sally Linky, who was an excellent employee and is a good friend of mine, has moved down to the surveyor's office where she is working for Warren and doing a much, much easier, less stressful job for the same pay. So sad for me, but good for her. But long story short, because of that, that created a void in our office, and because of the starting salary for county employees in the courthouse, it took us 8 weeks to find someone to fill that spot. It took about, it took a good 6 weeks of interviewing various candidates, and then the person who we selected had 2 weeks' notice, so there was an 8 week period where the court didn't have its full staff, and all I can say is it was terrible. But we got through that, and we now have our new employee. During this period where we had two people working rather than three, the two employees who remained there, Shelly Nutty and Deanne Reveille, basically came in early every day and stayed as late as they needed to stay, and they just did the work, each of them, of that extra person. Just because of the nature of being a judge, I can't deal with the public in a lot of situations. It's not appropriate. So they had to pick up a lot of slack, and they did it. They did a really good job. They didn't complain about it, and they really went above and beyond. And so the court kept running, but it was a strain. It was bad. So we have already appropriated in our budget money for Sally Linky's salary, which was not paid during these several weeks that she had already gone down to the surveyor's office, and we were trying to fill her position. So there's a sum of $1,055.75 that's already in the budget, already appropriated for salaries, that I want to split between these two other employees who basically just filled the slack and did the job, so that they could each have half of that. They absolutely deserve it, and they've earned it, but I have to get approval, as I understand it, to do it, even though that money's still in the budget because it's a salary. So I'm asking you to do that, because the employees are grossly underpaid, and at least this is a way that they can be compensated for extra work that they did. So that's why I submitted that. And then also, we do have the new employee now, and she's at the starting salary of a court reporter. That's Kristen, very nice, very suitable young lady. So I also need to have her salary approved, and it is the starting salary. And the only other thing I can say is, once again, just to reiterate, the reason it took so long to fill that position is because of the salary. I know a lot of people who are legal assistants, because I practiced law here for a long time. So we interviewed a lot of really, really good candidates who I would have hired, but they would not take the job. And it was, these are people who I've known for years, but they wouldn't take the job because of the pay. So that's something that is going to continue to come home to roost and be a problem. The reason it's a problem is, these aren't people who just sit and do rote clerical work. These are people who do hard jobs where it requires someone who's intelligent and is a self-starter. And the salary is just not commensurate with that. So we're going to continue to have problems. You have to have people who know how to enter a judgment of conviction and do an abstract of judgment and do these pleadings properly. We're not going to be able to get that if we don't have a salary that reflects that. So I'm asking you to please approve those two things. And just, I know every year I come in front of you and gripe about the salaries, but I've really lived through it now, having to replace this employee. I've seen how difficult that is to do.
That's good, because I thought maybe it took so long because you had so many lined up outside the door trying to get in.
You know, we did interview a lot of really good candidates. We did. But when they when we got down to the nitty-gritty of the salary, it just wasn't workable for them, and they would all be taking a huge pay cut, and they just couldn't do it, so.
Well, I've mentioned it numerous times. I applaud the employees working for what they get, because I don't understand, and I've seen a number of them working in other locations, and just to try and make ends meet, and I think it's unfortunate.
Yeah, and these two employees, like I said, they didn't complain. They just stepped right in and took up the slack and did the job and got it done. But it was very hard on all of us for 6 to 8 weeks. It was pretty rough. And so I really know that they deserve that money, so I hope that you'll...
Now, is this considered a bonus or a stipend? Are we putting this in the... I see we have
a
salary.
That's a one-time thing. That will never happen again. It's only,
okay,
because Sally was gone for that period, and so no one got her salary.
So yeah, that would be...
This will not carry over to 20. The way it's written on the salary ordinance, it's just for this last month of 2015, and then this expires.
It's a one-time deal.
Okay. Yeah.
That's all that is.
Because they came in, done extra
work.
Yeah,
this does not change the salary ordinance.
They did 1.5 jobs
during the budget.
Okay.
And got paid for one job.
I didn't know whether that was a stipend or if this is going to affect the salary for next year.
No, it will not recur. Even though I would like to make it recur, it will not. I'm not trying to slip that through so that won't happen in the future.
You know, some of these judges, you don't know how they write this stuff up here.
Well, I know. And you know, every year I do come down and try to raise their salaries, but
you
always cut it. So.
It'd be nice to do that every year, but
yeah.
We don't have the money, so I wouldn't want you to be writing that the wrong way, Judge.
Well, I try my best, but I see you're going to catch it, so.
To do in favor or against?
Favor.
Okay, for both of them? Okay, Councilman Wolf has made a motion in favor of both 144s. Is there a second?
Second.
Councilman Nobby, any further discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. Ayes have it, motion carries.
Thank you.
Please
thank
tell
you
them that
behalf.
It's a small token. I mean, you're the one put forth the effort for them, but we appreciate what they're doing too.
Well, this shows them that. So on behalf of them, thank you, because I can't think of two people who deserve that more. And then with regard to the new court reporter, is that all? That's all fine.
Stop.
Okay, thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Thank you, Judge. Health Department.
Good evening, how are you?
How are you doing?
I'm doing pretty good. I have grant funds that I would like to have a part-time clerical person come in 10 to 12 hours a week and help get caught up on paperwork for all the flu shots that we've given, the school shots that we've given, help organize the boxes of stuff for the needle exchange, and just help do things around the office that we're all bogged down in. And the grant, it's a grant we get every year. There's plenty of money in it. We don't ever use all of it.
Okay. So
if we could just get somebody to come in, that would be great.
I'll make a motion, we pass it.
Thank you. I'm not going to ask you this time.
I'll second.
We have a motion to approve the request for the 144 for the health department. Any further discussion?
I got a question.
Okay.
Paula, is this for a new part-time position?
Yeah, it would be a new person.
No, I want to clarify. The position has already been, we already have a job description for it. The position already exists. The person that's going to fill the position is new.
Was it from last month? The position? Did we just do that?
No, what?
Is that something else?
No,
I when I was here, that was a full-time
okay.
nurse, and that.
I knew there was something we just did.
Okay, I want to make sure I'm clear on this. This is a new part-time position.
Right. It's a new person filling
an existing
position.
Part-time. Okay, that makes a big difference.
This is a new person to fill an existing position that's currently vacant.
Right, and the funds in the grant are set aside for a clerical.
Okay. A very similar situation to what we have in our IT department. Right? I won't ask you to comment about that. But that's, just to be clear, this is the same situation we've got in IT. Okay. Now I'm clear. Thank you.
I have a question. You indicated 12 hours a week.
Yeah.
Do you have what is the amount of the total grant money that you have available for this, or is do you intend to limit it to $5,403.84?
Well, I think there's probably for clerical there is like maybe 8,000 left just from this year, and it's a grant that we have carryover funds that.
So that is my question. Do you intend to limit it to 12 hours a week?
Yes.
I think you said 10 to 12 hours a week.
10 to 12. Not over 12. I think that would be plenty.
Well, I forgot. Did we have a motion to approve? We did. In a second.
We did already.
And we've had discussion. Any more discussion, questions? If not, all those in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed, nay. Ayes have it. Motion carries.
Thank you. Guys, have
probation.
A good evening.
Probation.
I have a request of a 144 to replace our receptionist clerical at the probation department. Our current Alana friend has accepted the position for the administrative assistant community corrections liaison. That is paid for by the DOC grant, including her French benefits that I brought before the council at the last meeting. So that leaves her place open. And this would be for a starting salary at $17,247. And Alana, although she's still pretty much doing the receptionist job right now, she's getting paid from the community corrections grant. So as soon as I can fill this position, she can start full-time in the position that was created at DOC. So basically that's what I was asking for tonight.
Council?
How much are you saving on this? Because obviously the ones left was making more money, correct?
Yes.
How much more?
I grabbed the wrong folder. I think she has been here for 2 years, and so she got the last raise.
It's not
I
a lot
want to
more.
Say 22,000.
You asked 17, so you're looking at 5,000.
So yeah, 17,24. And I
what
honestly
do,
specifically.
What are you going to do with that extra $5,000?
I would love to split that with my clerical. They would be happy.
Going to give it to the IT.
And actually, I will say I have a clerical person that went to the judge's office quite a bit and filled in for the day and still did her job at juvenile probation. So I don't know how that's going to play out, but I think she, if anyone, should also be compensated, but I didn't know that was in play or anything, so.
I make a motion to approve this.
Second.
The motion to approve, seconded, and any further discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, nay. Ayes have it. Motion carries.
Thank you.
Sheriff Laughlin.
All right. Before I get to my 144, if I can, real quick, I just wanted to give you guys an update on the kitchen, how the contract with Gordon Food Services is going. Before we had switched over, we were serving meals for the best we can figure out about $5,465 a week. Since switching over to Gordon, the first week we served for $3,600, last week $3,400. So the goal was $3,200. Per average meal was $1.95 before the contract. We were at $1.09 the first week with Gordon, $1.06 last week. So Inmates are happy with the food. Not that that matters to a lot of people, but they do like the food. It does matter to the officers working in there. They think the quality is better. They're getting enough, but they're getting 2,000 calories a meal. Our nursing staff loves it. Our doctor loves it because they're not gaining enormous amounts of weight when they come to jail. So I would say Gordon is going exceptionally well, and I'd like to give some kudos to my kitchen staff. It has been a big undertaking for them. They have had to work a lot of extra hours. I know Judy worked about 10 straight days. A few of those were 14-hour days, learning new preparation, new recipes, everything, but I think she is starting to really like it as well. It's less work on them once they got it down. So just update you guys on that for you.
Before you get into 144, I also want to thank you for being willing and open-minded to that change. It, you know, it's not easy to accept change sometimes, and your kitchen staff too, so please pass that on to them. We appreciate their willingness to work with with the council and the commissioners on it. And the commissioners, you got to thank them too, because we've, of course, taking the responsibility from them and putting it on your shoulders, and you're taking it on. So
this created some more work for Beth too, and a few of us. So it's and I appreciate that. I'll pass it on. Those ladies have really done a wonderful job, and it's a Judy's been there 22 years, and asked somebody to say, let's reinvent the wheel. Let's totally do the opposite of what we're doing. Has been
we really don't want to make her mad.
We don't. No, I've been in there almost daily the first 2 weeks just to make sure she's calm. And doing good, and she's done great.
Put her in a police car once in a while and drive around the block, kind of cool her off.
Yeah, there you go, there you go. My 144 is for a jail officer position. It would be to replace Mike Snyder. Mike is going to retire. I went to the commissioners this morning. They asked me to come back in 2 weeks. There's some paperwork that they want to get squared away. Obviously, you guys don't meet again until next month. We'll bet you're meeting the 15th now, but I'd like to get this squared away if we can. I do have someone to hire for that position. We've interviewed several times over the past few months, and I've selected Brady Bolos to fill that position, if pending approval. Brady is the son of Randy Bolos from the city police, and Kelly Winta as well. So he is a tremendous young man, kind of reminds me of myself a little bit. Very, very polite and quiet and humble. So, and that this has worked out so far. So
I don't appreciate you insulting my stepson.
I'm sorry. But very nice young man. We've been working short on day shift for a while. Mike has been off for a little bit. We had another individual had some health issues last week that was off, so we've been running short. So getting him in, he had to put in 2 weeks notice, so it will take 2 weeks to get him in and get him training. So the quicker the better, and that's why I'm here instead of waiting until next month. So.
Sheriff, how much did we save on this? Because I know the guy retiring, Mike Snyder, is obviously making more than this. How much?
Quite a bit. How much we talked about? I think some of that may have been factored into our savings for the raises. We kind of factored that in, the difference. Mike is our most tenured jail officer. He's been there 25 years, so the savings is probably $11,000 to $12,000.
Okay. Put that towards IT.
There you go. I was going to ask you guys for a full-time IT guy for the jail, but...
Huh? You have some people in jail take care of those problems over there.
We probably do. We got a few MacGyvers in there. They can tattoo themselves with a paper clip and some ashes, so I'm sure they can work on computers too if needed to.
Joey, are you getting any DOC money in?
Yeah, I don't have any figures. I can get any figures. But yeah, we're trying to hold them as long as we can. I think they're figuring that out a little bit and trying to raise a ruckus to get out, but we're holding on to them as long as we can. So DOC out of the blue came down and picked up 11 a week ago, so I wasn't very happy about that, but there's not much you can do. They called us 3 days before and said we'll be down with the bus to pick up 11 inmates. So that's great.
What do you have right now,
population wise? I think 127 I think today. So we have had some drug busts, small drug busts, but keep picking up, and that's people we're going to hold on to. One has some serious medical stuff that we've dealt with, and attempted suicide in there the other day, so it's just been, you know, they're facing time. They don't want to be there, but we're going to keep them and take care of them, so.
I want to add that was a probation visit that started out with the last drink.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. That was one of our, probably one of our bigger heroin dealers, because all the guys in jail said, is he going to be okay? Is he going to be, well, he's my doctor on the outside, you know what I mean? So.
Do you tell them when they come in that there's new paint and you got Gordon's Food Service now?
Yeah.
Kind of lift your spirits up?
Yeah.
I'll second the motion.
Who made the motion?
I made the motion to approve.
The motion and a second to approve. Any further discussion? I will abstain. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. Ayes have it. Motion carries.
Thank you, guys. Have a good Christmas.
See you. There are no patrons here that have concerns that I'm aware of. People are probably concerned. If not, I'll entertain a motion for to adjourn.
So moved.
Motion to adjourn, second.
Second.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. Adjourned.